Hello folks, welcome to CodeCrux. This is Mahesh Guyani, and in this video I am going to talk about various properties of relations. If you don't know what relation is, then I have already made videos on crisp relations and fuzzy relations. I recommend you to watch that video first. The link of those videos is given in the description box. In this video, I'll be covering various properties of relations like reflexivity, anti-reflexivity, symmetricity, anti-symmetricity, transitivity. I'll be also discussing various types of relations like equivalence relation, partial order relation, tolerance relation, etc. And at the end, I'll be discussing how to convert tolerance relation into equivalence relation. A relation R bar is said to be reflexive if every element in the relation is related with itself. That is, if membership value of tuple x, x in R bar is 1 for all the element small x in the universe capital X. Consider the universe capital X is equal to 1, 2, 3, and the relation defined on the Cartesian product x by x is as shown here. For any tuple x, x in this relation is having membership value 1, and hence this relation is reflexive relation, or we can say that this relation is having the property of reflexivity. The relation R bar is said to be anti-reflexive relation if x, x is not part of the relation R bar. That is, the membership value of tuple x, x in R bar is 0 for all the elements x belongs to universe capital X. In this relation R bar, as we can see that the membership value of every tuple x, x is 0. So this relation is anti-reflexive relation. For anti-reflexive relation, the diagonal value in R bar will be always 0, whereas it will be 1 for reflexive relation. Relation is said to be symmetric if element x is connected with y and y is connected with x also. And this should be true for all x, y in the relation R bar. In other words, the membership value of tuple x, y in R bar should be same as membership value of tuple y, x in R bar. As shown in this relation, the membership value of tuple 2, 1 is 0.8, and that is same for 1, 2 also. The membership value of tuple 3, 1 is 0.1, and it is same for 1, 3 also. And it is true for all the tuples, and hence this relation is symmetric relation. Relation R bar is said to be anti-symmetric relation if the membership value of any tuple x, y in R bar is greater than 0, then the membership value of tuple y, x should be 0 for all x, y in universe. In the given relation R bar, as we can see that the membership value of tuple 2, 1 is 0.1. So the membership value of tuple 1, 2 should be 0, and it is 0. And this should be true for all the tuples, and that we can verify from the relation matrix itself. And hence, this relation is anti-symmetric relation. The properties we have discussed so far are common for crisp relation and fuzzy relation. But transitivity property is a bit different for crisp as well as fuzzy relation. For crisp relation R, if element X is related to Y, and y is related to z, then x must be related to z. In other words, we can say that if tuple x, y belongs to relation R and tuple y, z belongs to relation R, then tuple x, z must be present in R. For fuzzy relations, consider that lambda 1 represents membership value of tuple xi, xj, lambda 2 represents membership value of tuple xj, xk, and lambda represents membership value of tuple xi, xk. If lambda is greater than lambda 1, lambda 2 for all the possible values of lambda, then we can say that given relation is transitive relation. It is clear that less than or equal to is reflexive, anti-symmetric, and transitive, whereas less than is anti-reflexive, anti-symmetric, and transitive. For any given relation matrix R bar, it is very hard to manually check whether it is transitive or not, because we need to evaluate many pairs for different values of lambda. That is very, very difficult as well as prone to error. There is mathematical way to easily find out whether relation is transitive or not. For that, we need to compute R2 bar, which is nothing but composition of relation with itself. And in min-max sense, mu R bar 2 of x, z would be max of mu R bar of x, y and mu R bar of y, z for all the possible y in capital X. We say that relation R bar is transitive if R2 bar is contained within R bar. That is, for every tuple x, y, membership value of that tuple in R2 bar is less than or equal to membership value of same tuple in R bar. Given the relation matrix R bar, we have to check whether it is transitive or not. So to check the transitivity property, first we'll compute the composition of relation with itself, that is R2 bar. As we can see that the membership value of tuple 1, 1 in R2 bar is less than or equal to the corresponding tuple in R bar. This is also true for the second element also. However, it is not hold for this tuple, because the membership value of this tuple in R2 bar is 0.5 and it's 0.4 in R bar. We can see that for all the x, y pair, membership value of that pair in R2 bar is not less than or equal to mu R bar of x, y, and hence this is not a transitive relation. A relation is said to be similarity or the equivalence relation if it possesses the properties of reflexivity, symmetricity and transitivity. As we can see from this relation matrix, its all diagonal elements are having membership value 1, so it is reflexive. The transpose of relation matrix is the same as relation matrix itself, and hence this relation is symmetric also. And R2 bar of this relation is contained within R bar, so we can say this is transitive also. And so the given relation matrix is representing similarity or the equivalence relation. If R bar is similarity relation, then the complement of that will represent anti-similar relation. The membership value of tuple x, y in mu R bar complement will be same as 1 minus the membership value of same tuple in R bar. Or in other words, we can say that the relation is anti-similar if it is anti-reflexive, symmetric and transitive. In max-min form, the mu R bar complement of x, z is always greater than or equal to minimum of max of mu R bar complement of x, y and mu R bar complement of y, z. Given this relation matrix, we have to check whether it is anti-similar or not. So we will find out the complement of this relation, which looks like this. As we can see that all the diagonal elements are having membership value 0. So this is anti-reflexive relation. Transpose of this matrix is same as the matrix itself, and hence it is symmetric relation. And the R2 bar of this relation is contained within relation itself, so this is transitive also. And hence we can say that given relation matrix is having the property of anti-similarity, or it represents partial order relation. Weak similarity or the tolerance relation: if given relation is reflexive and symmetric but not transitive, then we can say that it is a weak similar or the tolerance relation. As we can see that for given relation matrix R bar, all the diagonal elements are having membership value 1, and hence it is reflexive. The transpose of matrix R bar is same as R bar, and hence it is symmetric. But the R2 bar of this relation is not contained in R bar, and hence it is not transitive. So this is a weak similar or the tolerance relation. R bar is said to be the order relation if it is transitive. R bar is said to be pre-order relation if it is reflexive and transitive. And R bar is said to be half order relation if it is reflexive as well as weak antisymmetric relation. The relation matrix for pre-order and half order relations are mentioned here. We can always convert the tolerance relation into equivalence relation by taking the composition of relation with itself. So until it is converted into equivalence relation, we should continue with this process. At some stage, it will become equivalence relation. Consider the example, we have to check whether it is equivalent or not. Equivalence relation is having three properties: reflexivity, transitivity and symmetricity. As all the diagonal elements have membership value 1, it is reflexive. the R is same as R transpose, and hence it is symmetric relation. And as we can see that for the tuple x1 comma x2, the membership value is 1. Tuple x2 comma x5 has membership value 1, but tuple x1 comma x5 is having membership value 0, so this is not transitive relation. So this relation is having property of reflexivity and symmetricity, but not transitivity. So this is a tolerance relation. It is not equivalence in the other words. Convert following relation into equivalence if it is not already. So this is a fuzzy relation, as we can see that membership values vary between 0 to 1. So first we need to check whether it is equivalence or not, and if it is not, we have to check whether it is tolerance or not. If it is tolerance, we can convert it into equivalence. For all mu r bar of x comma x, membership value is 1, so this is reflexive relation. Transpose of matrix is same as matrix itself, so it is symmetric relation. Or we can see that mu r bar of xi comma xj is same as mu r bar of xj comma xi for all the pairs, so this is symmetric relation. To check whether it is a transitive relation or not, let us consider lambda 1 is equal to the tuple x1 comma x2 whose membership value is 0.8. lambda 2 represents membership value of tuple x2 comma x5 whose membership value is 0.5. so lambda would represent membership value of tuple x1 comma x5, which is 0.2. as we can observe that lambda is not greater than or equal to minimum membership value of lambda 1 and lambda 2, and hence this is not a transitive relation. But as it is having properties of symmetricity, reflexivity, it is considered as a tolerance relation. We can convert this tolerance relation into equivalence relation by taking composition of relation with itself. So we can compute R bar dash as R bar composition R bar, and this relation matrix represents composition relation. Let us make some checks whether it is equivalence relation or not. So it is already satisfying the properties of reflexivity and symmetricity. Let us try to check whether it is transitive or not. So consider lambda 1 as a membership value of tuple x1 comma x2, lambda 2 as membership value x2 comma x4. So lambda will represent membership value of tuple x1 comma x4. So here also lambda is not greater than or equal to minimum of lambda 1 comma lambda 2, and hence this is not equivalence relation yet. So we need to find out composition again. This is the composition matrix, and if we'll make a check for pair x1 comma x3, x3 comma x2 and x1 comma x2, it is satisfying the condition that lambda is greater than or equal to minimum membership value of lambda 1 and lambda 2. However, it is true for this tuple only. It may not be true for all others. So we need to make a check for all the tuples. But it is tested that it is true for all the tuples. So this is finally a equivalence relation. The easier way to check whether it is transitive or not, what we can do is we can find out R2 bar for this relation, and we can see that whether it is contained in R double dash or not. If it is so, then it is transitive relation. That will be definitely true for this particular matrix. We have already tested it. You can try it by yourself. That's it for today, folks. See you in next video. If you think this video was useful to you, then please like, comment and share. Don't forget to subscribe the channel CodeCracks. Press the bell icon for the notification of latest videos. Stay connected, stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.